Here it is in front of you. Here's Skinner back.
Jeff Skinner's time in Buffalo is likely coming to an end. The Sabres are rumored to be exploring a buyout of the veteran winger after six seasons with the franchise. There's been highs, including 40 goals in his first year in Buffalo and a career-high 82 points in 22-23. And then there's been lows, including a cold stretch in which he had only 21 goals and 37 points during a 112-game stretch when Ralph Kruger was head coach. But one thing has remained consistent during his time in the 7-1-6. Zero team success. The Sabres haven't made the playoffs during Skinner's time in Western New York, and he's the only player in NHL history to appear in over 1,000 games without seeing the playoffs. Now, you can debate how much of a role his personal play has factored into that, or if he's just extremely unlucky, but the facts are the facts. Skinner has 3 years remaining on his contract at $9 million per. It's easily one of the worst contracts in the NHL, and has essentially been that way since the day he put pen to paper. At that time, the Sabres weren't in a position with their fan base to let him walk in free agency, but it hasn't worked out how either side has intended. A buyout now would offer instant cap savings heading into the offseason and enable the Sabres to be aggressive, but this potential move is more than just about the money. It's also about scheme fit and projecting the future. Skinner can score goals in bunches, averaging nearly 26 a season during his Sabres tenure, but his role was likely to be diminished under Lindy Ruff. He doesn't project as a first liner anymore, and I don't think they envision him on the second line with youngsters Dylan Cousins and Jack Quinn. That only leaves the third line as a realistic possibility, and he doesn't exactly fit the description of what Ruff has been clamoring out of his bottom six recently. When asked, Lindy has discussed wanting scrappy two-way players that are defensively responsible that make life difficult on opponents on the forecheck. Does that sound like Jeff Skinner? Not exactly. So if there's no fit with the top two lines, and he's not what they want on the third line, where does Skinner fit? That's the issue. So why not explore a trade? Well, that's where his contract comes to play. Skinner has a no-movement clause, and the Sabres can't trade him without his permission. His remaining salary, combined with his age, declining performance, make it really hard for any contending teams to justify taking a run at him, even if the Sabres did retain half his salary. Additionally, Skinner also has the ability to decline any moves to teams or cities that he'd want to avoid, making a buyout much more likely so he can personally choose his next destination. So at the end of the day, this move is likely going to happen for a variety of reasons. One, age, declining performance, and lack of scheme fit. Two, opens up instant cap relief for the Sabres to be aggressive this offseason. Three, allows them to move on from a bad contract and open up spots for better fits. Now, there are some negatives with making this move now. The Sabres salary cap will be impacted the next 6 years, including hits of $4.44 and $6.44 million in years 2 and 3, followed by $2.44 million the final 3 years. That's not nothing to brush off, but the salary cap is expected to increase in the future, which should soften the blow. At the end of the day, this is the type of move you make when you're turning the page. There's a bunch of pressure on the Sabres to make the playoffs this upcoming season, with Kevin Adams' job security potentially depending on it. That might lead to some short-term moves, but can you blame him? The long-term doesn't matter as much if you're not around to impact it. Ultimately, if you're buying out Jeff Skinner, you better be aggressive via trade or free agency, or else you're just wasting another season. The buyout will open up enough cap for the Sabres to potentially target a top six forward and additional bottom six depth to go along with their young core. We'll see what happens in the upcoming days. The Sabres have to wait until 48 hours after the Stanley Cup Finals officially conclude to go forward with the buyout. After that, the NHL Draft takes place Friday evening in Vegas, with free agency getting underway next week. It's certainly going to be an interesting time to pay close attention to the Sabres. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to Bunt Takes on YouTube and TikTok and follow my account on Twitter. Bunt Takes is presented by Batavia Downs.